What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today, I am here visiting Bromley's Corvettes, and no, my car isn't going back to the shop. This time, I'm actually here just to visit Doug. He has got over 25 Corvettes here in the shop. 25! He said it's the most amount of Corvettes he's ever had in the shop at one time. He's got a lot of cool projects going on, so let's go check them out.
You know, it's like a badass fun car to drive. And then he had but this one, they wouldn't even stay for him not paying for a hood.
Really?
To where it's like it's all buckled up like this,
uh-huh.
And they don't want to pay for a hood. You know?
What's up with this?
This one, we did full resto on it, with it's got the built 427 in it, and 4-speed and 370 rear, and all brake and suspension and custom side pipe, and it's here for like the passenger door needs some adjustments and some hinges. And then the alternator, one of the bolts that mounts the alternator actually broke off in the head.
Oh, wow.
Right? So we got to drill out what's left of the bolt. And good
stick
times.
Car.
Yeah, it's a nice. It's a 60 over 427, 600 horse and torque with 4-speed with a heavy duty clutch and 370 posi.
Nice.
And a 3-inch custom side pipe, you know, even though it's like the factory look.
Yeah.
We custom build it so it stays 3-inch instead of. Because the factory style is only like 2-inch.
Right.
And it's restrictive for anything over like, you know, 400 plus. You wouldn't get your full potential. They came in and decided, so now we're doing overhauling the engine and we're putting 5-tech fuel injection on it after you'd already paid to have all the original factory fuel injection totally gone through. And now we're upgrading the car. We're not even going to use the original for fuel injection on the car. Or he's going to save it. You know, and we're going to put modern 5-tech on it. But it's a 283 car originally being a 59. We're going to make it into a 383. So he wants to basically keep it looking stock and original, but it's going to be like double the horsepower, and then it's going to be way more drivable. It's, you know, it's like it's going to be deceiving because it's going to look stock like a sleeper kind of a car,
right.
But it's going to have way more power, and then it's going to have, you can still say it's a fuel injected car, it's going to be aftermarket fuel injection instead of stock, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, he wants to just do a five-tech, you know? So it's, you know, it's not going to go to waste. It's like he just paid to have all the factory stuff done, and we're not even going to put it.
Getting a new exhaust?
No, he's got some aftermarket on there to where he had come in for some service and some oil leaks and coolant leak and. No hurry to get the spare back whatsoever, and we've had no time to work on it.
Right.
That's got the LS7 crate and GM on and a 6-speed.
Nice.
So it's a pretty cool car.
LS7.
Got some issues that we've never got tuned right. Yeah, it's got some cool suspension. It's all like a tube chassis. It's an aftermarket.
C6 over here?
Yeah, it's been running for a while now. We just got to finish front brakes and finish putting the exhaust back on it, and then it's going to body and paint. He's going to do it bright red now, like a torch red. He was going to do a Lamborghini, like a tangerine or something.
Oh, yeah.
And now he's changed his mind to where he's going to paint it here and just do it bright, like a torch red, that red, you know. And,
right.
We still got to clean up the rear end some and then put the exhaust on. And we got to do the front brakes. And then it's going for money.
You gotta tell them to take those things off.
Yeah, they look so cheap. I did right away. I told them, I was like, man, you gotta ditch these covers. They just look really, they look fake.
This is Doug's car.
Yeah.
What year is this?
81.
81.
And then I find that I love these, the Corbeau seats, you know, to where it's like, man, they're like, they look so good and they're so comfortable.
And, nice.
They go match the car good as far as like they go with the whole theme of the car. And,
I was surprised that they even fit. They're really tall.
They say they don't. Like,
so what's going on with the white one here?
That just came in recently. It's already had a 383 done on it, but that's about it. The car, everything rubber on it is dried out and rotted, and everything that can leak is. So it needs cooling system in front end and brake work and rear suspension and trans, all the seals and gaskets. And, you know, it's got some real crap exhaust on it. Still has a single catalytic converter and smog pump. So basically, we're going to tear all that crap off and throw it on the ground, and we're going to redo all the brake and suspension, do a header and true dual X-pipe 2.5 inch, and aluminum radiator and dual electric fan, make the car real drivable. It's like it's got a decent motor in it, and that's about it.
Yeah.
So the coilover on the Red 68 is almost done. This one has been here for a long time. This one's almost done. Now he upgraded the cheap steering wheel.
That looks much better.
He wants a three spoke, the black leather with the polish to it. That's a 16.5, the stock original, like 68, and it's with non tilt. That wheel's kind of big for the car.
Yeah.
And so we're putting a 15 inch wheel on it. It makes it way easier to get in and out of the car, you know?
Yeah.
And it's still, you know, very comfortable. And he's getting the Hurst shifter. He's got stock shifter in it right now. And so we're upgrading it to the Hurst. His shifter's pretty sloppy, and everything else on the car is all, you know, aftermarket AC, an electric headlight conversion, and 600 horse motor, and aluminum radiator, and electric fan. The white color is yellow, all faded and teared up.
Yeah.
We just got it back and painted. It's got to be all fully detailed.
Nice.
And then we got the wheels are black powder coated. The original Z06 wheels are next door.
Yeah.
These are just some rollers on there just for paint. And so it's getting windows tinted. It's getting all the marker lights blacked up. And it's got black wheels and black centers. And then this car's almost done. It's getting stereo. The double din stereo in it. But it was ugly when it came in. It was like four different shades of yellow. It had some, all the little wood discs and all the front dimensional aluminum radiator, long tube header. We're doing custom 3-inch side pipe. Did the whole rear end. Did the 17-inch wheels on it. Did all the color sand and buff and polish, filled chips and scratches and things. It just needs a final detail, we're almost done with it.
What's the other one over here?
72, got all wood, all front suspension built. It's getting a built 700 R4, 2800 stall. Get some rear end work. Digital Dakota gauges, Vitek fuel injection.
That's a nice touch. I've never seen that before.
Yeah, they're kind of like a, not really chrome, but kind of like a silvery kind of like a coated, you know?
Yeah. What color is that?
It's a candy kind of a burgundy, they call it, that was done like, I think he said like 20 years ago, 20 something years ago. This was more popular back in, I don't know, 80s, 90s. Cooling system, fuel system stuff, his is a 4-speed car, so he's not looking to go to the Tremec 5-speed at the moment, but, you know, he may.
Yeah.
Things escalate quickly around here. A car comes in for something, and the next thing you know, it's turning into a bigger project. And,
so what's he getting done?
All the wheelwork brake, the whole front suspension, aluminum radiator, you know, so the whole cooling system, fuel system. Tune up, you know, as far as like distributor plug wires, you know, basically. Shifter is fine.
Back at the house, that was pretty good to visit Doug and see all the cool projects that he's got going on right now. He had about 15 or 16 cars physically in the shop, plus 6 or 7 outside. And then next door at the body shop, he has another 5 or 6 going in for some body work. And then he's got a handful of other cars waiting in the back lot, getting ready to be worked on as soon as he's got some room. And then sounds like he's got some cars on a waiting list right now too, waiting to get in. So good that he's staying busy. Some really cool projects. Some of those cars have some interesting stories. They're family-owned cars that have been given down the line from father to son or daughter, stuff like that, or somebody's passed away and has left the car to somebody, and it sounds like they're keeping it in the family. So good to see that. Always, you know, Corvettes always come with a story. It's part of the best part of Corvettes are the stories that people tell about them, and so it's good to see that people are keeping their inherited Corvettes in the family and getting them fixed up and restored. So So yeah, we may check in time to time with Doug to see what he's got going on. Yeah, pretty interesting stuff. And just like that, that is going to do it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. Also, if you are on Instagram, My Corvette Life is on Instagram. I will put the handle down here at the bottom of the screen. Go check it out on Instagram. I post a few times a day usually. And that's it. So, we'll see you guys later. Take care.